This video has been made possible by our sponsor, Squarespace. Whether you need a domain, website, or online store, check it out for a free trial. And when you are ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/creatnprocess to save 10% off your first purchase. Make your next move with Squarespace. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating another blend vector art. But this one is totally different from our previous designs. In the previous vector art episode, we have created animal blends, tube vector art, gradient blending, and text blend. But in today's video, I'm going to share a very unique technique. Only then only you'll be able to create this blending effect. As you can see, the blending strokes are a little unusual. Some portions have broader thickness and some are narrow. So let's begin with the designing process. Open a new Illustrator document. And if your artboard is really filled up like mine, then draw the new artboard using the artboard tool. We'll be creating a panther head for this design. Let's draw the outline of the panther using the pen tool. Click and drag to create the smooth curve. And draw the front outline of the head. Let's finish the last anchor point in the shape of an arc. Now using die selection tool, let's tweak each of the anchor points to maintain the shape. Adjust the handles to set the curve angles. This step is very important. The refinement of the strokes will give you a perfect blend art. Give some time to this part. You can even trace it by using the photograph of an animal. Once it's completed, increase the stroke thickness to around 3 points. Now from here, it's the most important part of our tutorial. We're going to give thin stroke to some region and thick stroke to the rest. So to give that effect, select our curve path and select this tool. It's a width tool that will help in adjusting the thickness of the stroke. Click here and drag it inward to narrow down the thickness. Add a broader thickness around here, click and drag outward to increase the thickness. Narrow down the thickness at the nose region and increase the thickness on both the opposite sides. This will add a slope to the outline. Once it's done, again let's set its overall thickness to around 3 points. In the next step, we're going to create the blend effect. So with the Alt pressed, click and drag to create a duplicate of the outline. And we're going to use this curve to create the blend. That's because it will not give the same effect if it's done in another way. Let me show you with an example. Let's draw out a curve path like this. And adjust the stroke thickness using the width tool. Now, if we draw out another similar curve and did the same adjustments, then selecting both the curves, if you apply a blend effect, the in-between blend lines will give a uniform thickness. So to get the same features in the blending curves, we'll create a duplicate of the first curve and apply a blend to it. Now the blending curves have the same effect as in our outline curves. If you do it in any other way, it will not give the same effect. If we tweak the curve, it will not be distorted, but if you again adjust the stroke thickness, then it will lose its feature. So keeping that in mind, let's create a blend for our design. For the back curve path, adjust the anchor points and the handles to create the back outline. Since it's a single curve, we'll be a little creative and use it to create the eye and the ears. Adjust each of the anchor points so that there's no tangent. Everything should be smooth. Take your time and do this properly. This part is very important. Once you feel everything is right, select both the curves, then using the blend tool, click on the first curve, then on the second curve. Now, double click on the blend tool to open the attribute panel. Here, you can decide how many steps you want. Let's set it around 44 and click OK. Here in our eye region, there are some overlapping curves. Let's tweak it using the die selection tool. Do the final adjustments with the overall curves. Now, if you want to create another animal head, like wolf or a dog, you can just create a duplicate of the blend shape and tweak the anchor points of the mouth region. If you extend it a little bit and narrow down the jaw and the eyebrows, it will form a different animal blend. Now let's create a cover for our design. So let's do it in a new Photoshop document. Open a new document with 2000 by 1200 dimension, then drag and drop both the vectors and scale up their size using the transform option. Here I want to talk about one more thing. If you check out our file, you'll see a blend vector with a gradient color applied. To create that, you just have to select the blend shape and apply gradient color by clicking here. This will remove all the effects and give you a uniform design. You can adjust the gradient color on the gradient panel and tweak it as per your look and feel. Now for our cover, what I did here is, I created a square box on the background. Then double click on the layer to open the layer star panel. Here apply color overlay. Choose magenta color, or you can use this color code and click OK. I have also added a nice text on the top. And finally, we have completed designing under blending vector art. It was quite different from our previous design. This technique will give you a different feel to your blend art, and we are done with our design. Also, I'd like to thank Squarespace for supporting the channel. It's an all-in-one platform where you can go and create a beautiful websites. They have got this really easy to use platform. They have got designer's template, domains, and really good customer service 24/7. You can easily open online stores that allow you to manage your products, orders, and inventory easily. If you want to try it out, go to squarespace.com/creatnprocess to save 10% off your first purchase. Highly recommended. Make your business stand out with Squarespace. Thanks for listening, guys. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. See you in the next episode.